The problem that our team was trying to solve is delivering vaccines to hard to reach places, mainly because of the need for refrigeration, or what we call a cold chain. And so right now, almost all vaccines available commercially require to be refrigerated at all times, from manufacturing to all the way to the end user. So our team want to develop a way to stabilize these vaccines so that they do not require to be refrigerated. And so what we've developed is a stabilization technique for vaccines.
Not only would it be very helpful to a very developed country like Canada or US or Europe, but it would be very, very helpful to Africa, Asia, an area that they desperately need vaccine, but they don't have the infrastructure to have the vaccine. This technology has the potential to really change the way vaccine are being delivered and administered around the world.
The issue, though, is that even though we have a vaccine that we know works very well in optimal conditions, we still have to get that vaccine to the people who need to be vaccinated in such a way that the vaccine maintains its activity. And so this technology that we've developed, in theory, has applications for, you know, many, many different types of viruses beyond just influenza virus and herpes simplex virus, which are what we tested in this study specifically.
The first ingredient is the vaccines. The vaccines are exactly the same vaccines that are currently available in the markets and that are available for people to use and to be deployed around the world. So we didn't want to reinvent the wheel in terms of the vaccines that are going to be utilized. That ingredient was already available. The two other ingredients are sugars. And they are sugars that have been approved for human consumption, for injection in human beings. So our goal is to be able to reach out to those people that are in the most difficult to access places, to try to preserve those precious lives, and at the same time to create a situation where there is a prevention of infection coming out from those remote areas that are more unprotected from a vaccination point of view, that is going to affect the rest of the world.